Okay, guys, so I just want to say, because I know some people struggle, they have injuries, they have maybe not as good of body strength yet, you know, just different things. And some of the moves, especially when you get into these, the further along in the phases, they're going to get harder because they do combo, more combo moves and faster moves. So I just want to say, don't get discouraged. Like, seriously, you guys, most of you know I have back issues, herniated disc, bulging disc, three of those, probably herniated by now, facet joint problems, arthritis in that area. I do have degenerated disc in that area. I have degenerated disc in my neck, could be bulging, could be herniated, I don't know, I haven't had that checked in 3 years, 4 years, something like that. SI joint problems, osteoarthritis in my hip, you know, just all kinds of stuff. And sometimes there are days like today, and women, men, shut your ears for 1 second. Women, that time of the month, my cycle, the week before, my body just is even in more pain. I have muscle spasms all the time. I'm in pain. You know, even though I had nerve ablations, which helped in that area, it doesn't help everything because they can't do nerve ablations everywhere. And in the areas they can, insurance doesn't pay for it and it's kind of expensive. So I just deal with it the best I can, do an exercise and things. But the week before, my body just even spasms. It's like clenches tight, because muscle spasms are your body's way of protecting an injury. So it's limiting your mobility so you're not injuring it more so it can heal. Well, muscle spasms in themselves cause pain. So it's kind of like a catch-22. You know, it's doing its job to protect you, but it freaking hurts like crazy. So the week before, it's like my body just wants to tighten up and do, you know, very little mobility. So my point is, there are going to be times that you can't do certain moves. You know, some of these moves may go too fast or you get frustrated and discouraged. Do not get discouraged. Don't get frustrated. And definitely, this is a time when some people decide to quit because they're like, it's getting too hard. I can't do this. Do not quit. That's all I got to say on that part. Don't quit. But what you can do is, all right, let's say like one of the moves today is that burpee, firecracker, whatchamadigger thing. All right, so I just held plank because my body's not wanting to do that at all. I mean, I could do, you know, the twist thing, but the burpee, firecracker, that's not happening, and then that fast movement. So I just held plank. Find another move that you can do. If you can only do one of those moves, say like, you can only do, say, I'm thinking that's the right combo, I can't remember, but you know, you're doing this, right? But you can't do the combo move. Just continue doing this, okay? Or like I did on, I just held a plank. Let me tell you, planks are like the best freaking exercise move there is for like your total core. It's like, you know, it doesn't just work, say, here, it's like total. Plus your arms and your legs and your glutes and your quads, it works a whole lot of things. But hold a plank. See how long you can do that without being out of breath and starting to sweat. So holding a plank is not like you're not working out. It's probably going to give you a better workout than maybe that move that you cannot do and you're getting frustrated with. So find another, or do one of the other moves. Especially today, it's cardio. The whole point is keeping, you know, your heart rate up, right? Do something else. Jog in place, walk in place, do jumping jacks. You know, whatever it is, just don't get frustrated. Don't get discouraged and don't give up. Find a way to make it work for you.